Hi, and welcome to the VSDC channel. Have you checked out the latest VSDC 9.1 update yet? We bet you're eager to know all the details. Just recently, we released a new update of VSDC 9.1. We'll cover the exciting new changes and features that have been introduced to enhance your video editing experience. Let's start. One of the highlights of this update is a new algorithm for creating video transitions by overlaying files. To use this feature, select a file on the timeline and hold the Alt key, and create an intersection between two clips. A transition area will automatically appear at this point. You can do it in two ways, either by moving the file itself or by adjusting its border. For more details, check our guide by following the link in the description. By overlaying files using one of the methods described above, you automatically create a fade transition. But you can easily switch it out for another by accessing the Templates window. If it is closed, open it in the View tab. There are two groups of templates available, the first in the Transitions folder and the second in the Transitions collection. Select the appropriate transition and drag it onto the transition area. The transition is now replaced. You can change the duration of the transition by dragging and dropping its borders, just as you would edit a regular border. You can also restore borders with the Shift key held down. To remove an added transition, find Remove Transition in the drop-down menu. The transition will then be reset to the standard fade effect. If you want to remove it too, just drag the border to make the transition disappear. RAW and BRAW support. Next up, VSDC supports professional video codecs RAW and BRAW, or Blackmagic RAW, enabling you to edit these high-quality formats directly in the program. This update opens up new possibilities for color grading and editing, thanks to the inclusion of built-in Blackmagic LUTs. This feature ensures your RAW and BRAW footage can be edited with the same ease as other video formats. Christmas templates. Just in time for the holidays, we've added over 70 New Year's Eve templates, exclusively to VSDC Pro. To access these festive templates, head over to the Templates window, pick your favorite, and drag it onto your scene. These templates are customizable to fit your video perfectly. Free waveform. Another significant update is the availability of the waveform display in the free version of VSDC. This feature visualizes the audio track below the video files and is now accessible by clicking the waveform icon. This addition makes your audio editing more intuitive, especially for synchronizing sound with visuals. Advanced audio and video codec settings. Video and audio codec settings at the expert stage used to be available for quite a limited number of codecs. Now you have the ability to fine-tune a broad spectrum of video and audio codecs, enhancing the output quality of your projects. Moreover, we have introduced hardware acceleration for MPEG-2 codec, and for those aiming for the highest quality, FLAC format is now available for lossless audio compression. Optimized interface. The next improvement is aimed at the user interface, allowing you to reset to default settings easily. This is particularly useful if you've modified the interface and wish to revert to the original layout. Improved shift effect. The next change upgrades the shift effect. From 9.1, this effect allows you to enable object movement within your scene. To do this, switch the mode to Without Clipping. And now, when you change the shift parameters, the object moves. Moreover, a percentage offset mode has been added for more precise shift level setting. Cursor position option on the timeline. Enhancements to the timeline navigation mean you do not necessarily need to click on a file to bring up a cursor action. A right click anywhere on the timeline does the trick. Remembering cutting and splitting window position. Cutting and splitting window in VSDC now remembers its position and size after closing. Next time you open it, you don't need to set it up again. We highly recommend upgrading to VSDC 9.1 to take full advantage of these new features and improvements. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials and updates on VSDC. See you next time!